The much anticipated second edition of 3FM's Tour to Ghana is where it begins.
This is the way I want her to be.
Okay.
This is the Central University where the cycling event is taking place. About 120 cyclists, men and women, old and young, assembled to ride with a boy. The preparatory stage has been impressive as all stakeholders have put in measures to ensure a successful event. Participants prepare adequately by making sure jerseys, props, and everything required for a good race is in good shape. Cyclists busily attend to their bikes since the state of their bicycles is a contributory factor to a win or lose in this competition. For most cyclists, a free ride prior to the race is necessary to assess the state of their bikes and possibly check mechanical faults before starting the race. Most of the cyclists are unaware of what is ahead, but are hopeful to be a part of the first 10 cyclists after the total 289-kilometer race. Breaking away from the tension, the Levites generation from Central University put up a beautiful choreography to open the ceremony. Grace, oh, 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 grace.
This is the 3FM Tour to Ghana, second edition. After last year's amazing, amazing event, we have extended the tour. So it is now 289 kilometers. Of course, starting right here from the Central University College through Ho, where we make a stop. And then tomorrow we continue from Ho all the way to Dodowa, where we would be finishing at the Valley View University. Now I'm going to be inviting a couple of people to just give us a brief talk on what we are to expect and what this is all about. And none other than the 3FM head of station, Lois Kisiedu. She is going to be with me here to talk about this particular event. Please, with a round of applause, let's welcome Lois Kisiedu. Oh, you're here already. That's very energetic. Anyway, what are we to expect in this year's edition?
So I experienced last year's, and I must say that it was very exciting. And you know, at the heart of the 3FM brand is that transformative experience that we give to our listeners and our community. So we want to see the second edition go smoothly, and we have everything in place. We have our ambulances, we have the policemen on the ground to support and make sure that the cyclists are safe on the ground. We are expecting a very exciting ride and a very safe one at that.
And from what you've seen of the cyclists, do you think they are ready for this?
I think they are, if you ask me. I think they are. They are in there warming up.
Yeah.
Yes, I think they are very much ready.
I'm sure we'll be having shots of them of course, warming up. This is a 3FM Tour to Ghana, and we are at the Central University College, of course, at the entrance of it, where we are going to be starting. I see the start line there. Yeah. I wish I was racing with the guys, but Charlie, I have to hold the microphone, so I'm here.
Got your cycle. I want to wish all the cyclists the best of the best. Mm-hmm. May the fastest cyclist win.
All right. So right from Lois there, may the fastest cyclist win. So at this point, I'm going to be inviting Mr. Kofi Boakye, chairman of the Greater Accra Cycling Association and vice president of the Cycling Federation. You know, when I was first told there was going to be a Kofi Boakye, I thought you'd be the COB. Anyway, but you are obviously with the cyclists most of the time. You've seen what they can do in different events and everything. What can you tell us about these cyclists for today?
Well, today we are expecting something wonderful. We're expecting something new. I have seen the guys prepare for this race over the days and weeks past. So I guess with the flat terrain that we have today, something excellent is going to come out of it.
In your estimation, how many hours will it take these guys to finish? To hoe? Not the entire race, but to hoe?
We have 128 kilometers to go.
Yes,
right?
Yes, 128 kilometers.
Maximum
3 hours.
Maximum 3 hours.
That's when we'll have our first winner.
Yes.
I mean, I will have our winner, sorry.
Yes.
All right, so let's see who that will be, obviously.
The cyclists are ready to race for the tour, but first, let's go through the rules of the game. Equal point on the final stage will be judged by time. Hotspot will be awarded to the best hotspot winner by points at the final stage calculation. A person will be disqualified when found by the following: pushed by a car or moto, picked by a car or moto, showing disrespect or misbehaving in public. Stage winners should come to the podium with well-dressed riding feet. The time has come for the cyclist to hit the road. For the first day of the tour, cyclists are to cover a total distance of 155 kilometers from Central University to Ada, Sogakope, Adidome, final destination. A 120 cyclists made up of professionals, amateurs, individuals, leisure riders have joined the tour to become Ghana's finest cyclists. The event organized by 3FM is aimed at improving cycle as a sport discipline. A special mention to the Cycling Federation for making this great tour possible. Thank you. from Central University heading towards Adan. On steadily, some riders want to get into the initial break of the race as they try to start and initiate a breakaway. There's the policeman trying to get the riders ready for the neutral zones. Stake for the participants are cash amount, products, and services from 3FM and sponsors. The ultimate prize is a cool 7,000 CDs for the winner, investment package, and consolation prizes for all the contestants. This second edition has people cycling all the way from the north to join the race. That, we must say, is an interesting accomplishment. Most of the cycling clubs in Ghana are representing in the second edition of Tour de Ghana 2022. A two-day tour with a staggering 289-kilometer distance. Gradually, the cyclists approach Adan. One of the key areas of the tour is to explore the tourism potential in the various towns. Adan is a town located along the Volta River off the Accra-Aflao motorway. It is a perfect place for fishing and for seafood lovers. For relaxation, get to the Adan Beach Resort.
This is the TFF Tour du Ghana, and we are live all the way to Soga Coppin. We've bypassed Adan and so we bypassed again, but we are en route to Soga Coppin. So as you can see, these are the riders behind me, and they are really making a headway through. There are a lot of challenges for them, but they've been able to still see it. The man who took up the race last year have got a lot of challenges up on the menu for him. Steven couldn't make it. He's part of the top 10 though, but he's really struggling to see whether he can be first. But I must tell you that it's been so good, and these are the bikers going through. A lot of speed, a lot of agility, and you can't beat them. Good stamina cyclists arrive at Soga Coppin, home to the Lower Volta Bridge, which connects Soga Coppin to Sokwe. The town is known for its river tourism and mass bread production. Mostly Aigbe biscuit, Keta schoolboys, Abodo. Cyclists enjoy the coolness of the river and change strategy as they ride to the next town. Town folks cheer them on as they ride gallantly to their next destination, Adido.
This cycling race wouldn't have been possible without the sponsorship of Super Yogo from Fan Milk, Prudential Life, your life insurance partners, Lonat from Bliss GV, Regiman Capsules from Reggie True Vine, Over Milk and Foods, Kel Chaco Toothpaste from Samara Pharmacy, King Legend Energy Drink, Verna Mineral Water, Investcorp Limited. Expressions are indifferent as cyclists ride with focus to Adidome's small town with mountains as its unique features. Much appreciation to the police, ambulance service for providing security and support to make this race a success. At this point, some cyclists try to chase the leading group. Teams are closing the gap as they near the first finish line. There's undulating roads, so cyclists change gears to suit the road and the race to the final line at Ahoy. Back at Ahoy, town folks wait anxiously to meet these great cyclists. Their jubilant mood describes the successful 155-kilometer distance covered by the cyclists from Central University. The atmosphere is colorful, the energy charged, drawing attention from all directions. In no time, the cyclists appear with extra speed as they reach the finish line.
The cyclists are getting closer, of course. This is the finish line. Who will be our first in hope? It will be staggering to know who and to know how. It will be absolutely impressive to know how the man finishes. Over here. Who is it going to be?
Oh my God!
Beautiful! It's a man with a 33 tag, and he is our number one. 40 is our number two. 73 is our third for this particular trip. You can tell just how tired these gentlemen are.
Tired legs indeed.
Tired legs, tired hearts, tired minds. But this is the 3FM tour. The number 84 has also been here through the finish line. Impressive. 66 follows. And then to the bunch. And
there you
then
have
to
them.
The bunch. Side of top 10 this time in Ho. But what is it for these gentlemen? Remember, we are only counting up to 21 cyclists who will be graded in the second race tomorrow. For today, it's only 21 cyclists, the first 21 who will be graded tomorrow. It's a stage point system. Give you a sign of greater things to happen tomorrow. I know they are tired, but tomorrow is the real finish.
Yeah,
tomorrow is when they win prizes.
Tomorrow will be very, very greater and then tougher than today's event. Because tomorrow is the final.
Tomorrow is the D-Day.
Yeah, tomorrow is the D-Day. Tomorrow is the final. So as you all know, today they are using today as warm-up. Even the one we are seeing today,
hey,
they
are using warm-up.
Warm-up in Pony. Warm-up in So tomorrow it will be very, very terrible. In fact, Gasol will put you like a rule play.
4 hours. How do you feel after this race?
I'm still feeling strong. I think I can do more than 100 kilometers in addition to what we've already done.
You can do more than 100 kilometers,
yeah,
in addition to what you've done?
Yes.
One medrana.
It's all about training.
It's all about
it's
training. All right, but we saw you. What team is this? What team are you in?
River Park Cycling Club.
Say it slower.
River Park Cycling Club.
River Park Cycling Club. Where are you guys from?
Okay, we have many of the clubs in other regions.
Okay.
But the main one is in Accra.
Okay. Yeah. The main one is in Accra.
I'm from Brunahafu.
Okay.
So I need to be precise.
Oh, great. You are from Brunahafu. So you came all the way to Accra to compete.
Yes.
Now, let me ask you, based on what you've experienced so far, how are you looking at the distance from Ho to Oyibi tomorrow?
Well, we will still do our best.
But we are going to be rewarding you with a yellow jersey for a fantastic job done. Anthony Boache. You see, when I'm rewarding him, I want to hear your applause, okay? Let's celebrate this gentleman. 4 hours of cycling is not easy. If I say some of you should ride to the runabout, you'll be tired. And so I appreciate him. So we are going to be doing that. And of course, doing that is going to be the team from the commercial department handing over the yellow jersey to the MCE. Let's
please
get up for
together.
Anthony, please turn to the cameras for me. This is Anthony Boache. Anthony Boache. He finished first to Ho. But remember, he's not the overall winner. Tomorrow, we are going to be finding out who wins it all when we finish the race in Ho. I know some of you might be confused. All right, but before I explain
and
the
he's
rules,
rocking the yellow already.
Rocking the yellow jersey as it is. And that is going to be the symbol for him. He might want to frame this into his room and then tell
so
his children, children and children.
Yeah.
All right.
We so have another presentation from Samara.
Some other prizes.
Samara Pharmacy, Kale Charcoal Toothpaste, and some souvenirs from Kale Charcoal Toothpaste as well. Yes, thank you so much. Still products from Oba. Oba Evaporated Milk is saying that, yo, Anthony, go and drink some milk and get some energy for tomorrow to continue the journey. It's not going to be easy. Tomorrow is another trip. This is from Super Yogo from Fun Milk Ghana Limited. So people, please put your hands together for all our sponsors and making it happen. Thank you, Super Yogo. They say go and drive that. And also, yes, our people from Malco Girls, please make some noise.
I like that. But also, just so you know, maybe this will ginger you just a little bit. Tomorrow, we have a cash prize, a fat cash prize, awaiting the winner, of course, the overall winner of the two races, and then also an insurance package plus investment package from our sponsors that will total 12,000 Ghana cedis as well. But there's a cash prize also awaiting you tomorrow. Wow! Riding for 4 hours and over. How do you feel? How do you feel? Let's get up, let's get up, let's get up, let's get up,
yeah,
let's get up, let's get up for them.
Let go!
A self-motivator there. What's your name?
Eric.
Eric.
And Mary, my wife.
And Mary, your wife. Yes. Okay, so please let Ken handle the microphone here so the wife speaks for me. But for you, how was the race? Because I drove past the two of you. I saw a four-wheel drive behind you. I'm sure maybe supporting you or something. That's your person. That's your driver.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so the four-wheel was supporting you, but I drove past you, and I was asking myself if you were the leaders of the amateurs. Are you the champions of the amateurs in this race?
Yes, yes.
She's the champion, 57-year-old. How do you feel?
Oh, well, it was tough. Arriving around Adaklu, I was...
You know Adaklu?
Yes. Yes. We climbed Adaklu. Okay. 2 months ago, we were there by mountain bike. Going from Ho to Adidome.
Okay.
And then we stop at Adaklu and we climb Adaklu.
Yeah.
And then we get back to the bike and go to Adidome.
So have you done the full stretch before, the two of you?
Yes, yes, already.
Okay, so you already practiced it. But how was it today? Was it different?
Yes, it's always a race. But I really enjoy to ride with my wife. It's lovely days.
It's a romantic feeling for the two of you. You met on a bicycle?
No. On the windsurf.
On windsurf.
On a windsurf. You guys are sportsman and woman.
Yes.
but let me just ask you, what country are you from?
France.
Oh, you're France. Mm. You're also France. Mm. So you're French.
Yes.
So looking at the race here in Ghana, how different is it from what you experience in France, especially the Tour du Ghana? Tour du France.
Yes, but frankly speaking, it's super well organized, and really want to thank you, the organizer. Because it's not easy, so thank you very, very much. And 2 days is fantastic, so super well done. It's the reason why we want to participate, to really thank you.
We have the MC for Ho right now, Honorable Divine Richard Komla Bossen, and he's joining us to have a conversation briefly about the experience so far. We brought it to Ho, and so what is his experience? What was he expecting? And what do you think of the competition coming to your municipality?
This is very wonderful, and sporting is health, and health is cut. And you are in the oxygen city of the Republic of Ghana, for that matter, the cleanest city in the whole country.
You said
we
oxygen
can see
city.
Oxygen city. You breathe fresh air here, right?
You breathe fresh air here, and it's the best place to sport. Mm.
So what are we to expect from you today or tonight? We hear you have something amazing for us this evening.
You know, I always have this concept, visit Ho, experience the whole Ghana. So once you are in Ho today, we are going to go on a tour with you to experience the whole of Ghana in Ho this evening at the Almighty Jubilee Park.
Indeed. These cyclists have proven they have all it takes to be the best cyclists. Unfortunately for the defending champion and those who couldn't make it to the top 20, there's hope for the second day of the tour. They need to re-strategize to leave a footnote.
This is the second edition of the 3FM Tour to Ghana, of course, covered also by our sister station, TV3. My name is Thierry Nyan, I've been your host, and I'm here with Ken Addo, of course, also with TV3, Head of Entertainment Media General.